Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, Arrangements in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, why don't you join the over 11,000 other people who have already liked and subscribed to this show. They even click the little bell icon, and some even leave messages below the video. So this is something that I was sure that I'd covered. Turns out, whenever I do a live class, I typically cover it. So that's probably what I was thinking, because searches I couldn't find it on YouTube or within my ProPresenter live training community, Church Tech U. So I thought I would remedy that mistake and go ahead and make one for you. So let's head over to my computer and we'll take a look. So here we are in ProPresenter, and let me just choose a song here. I think this Amazing Grace is the one I'm going to use. Okay, so you'll already see that I had that up, but right up here, right under where it says Pro Content, if you're on 7.13 or newer, I think it is. Before that, it was the store. So right under that, there is this little icon that I'm circling with my mouse. It looks like an arrow pointed one way, an arrow pointed the other way, and three boxes in the middle. So think of that as the arrows are rearranging the boxes, which are slides. So that's what that is. So let's click on that. And you'll notice by default, you're in the master arrangement. That is when you import a song, I'm going to encourage you to import it with every last verse, every last chorus, if there's a pre-chorus, if there is an alternate bridge, any of that. Anything that you may possibly use, even if you think, we'll never in a million years use that, I want you to import it with that. And I'll show you why here in just a second. Hey there, aspiring ProPresenter Pro. Are you tired of getting tangled up in tech trouble? Want to impress your congregation with mind-blowing visuals? Well, look no further. Introducing ProPresenter 7 training at Church Tech U, your secret weapon for unlocking ProPresenter's full potential. Join me as I dive into the world of captivating presentations, smooth transitions, and jaw-dropping effects. From beginner basics to advanced tips and tricks, I've got you covered. Don't miss out on this amazing opportunity. Visit churchtechu.com/free trial for a free month now. Did I mention it's free? And revolutionize your ProPresenter game. Your congregation will thank you. So, with arrangements, you can have several versions of the same song saved in the what under the one song in the library. So you don't have to have, in this case, Amazing Grace Old, Amazing Grace Long, Amazing Grace Short, etc. So that saves some confusion and searching, etc. So thing number one. So the master arrangement, when you bring in the song, bring in every possible word that could ever be sung with that song. Now, whether you actually use it or not, doesn't matter all that much, because we're going to use arrangements instead of the master arrangement. So the first thing that we're going to do is create a new arrangement. So if I go down here, you'll notice that I have a couple of arrangements already, but I'm going to click on new arrangement, and let's call this something that I'm going to remember. So in this case, I'm going to do 1, 3, 4. This is to honor the minister of music at my church growing up, who actually 1, 2, 4. He seemed to always say, we're going to sing the first, second, and last stanzas of a song. I thought that there must be something theologically wrong with the third one, because we never sang it. So That's to honor you, Jerry. So there we go. Now you'll notice that when I typed in the name, I still have all four. No problem. Mouse over the one you do not want and click on the X and it goes away. And you'll notice that now I have verse 1, verse 2, and verse 4 right there, ready to go. If on the odd occasion we might want to sing all of them, I can just go back to master and immediately it's right there. No need to disable certain slides, nothing like that. That's good to go. So that just makes it really easy for me to make an arrangement with some, but not all the content. But you might be thinking, well, what if I want to have a repeat of one of the verses, like maybe 1, 2, 4, 1 again? Well, no problem. Let's create a new arrangement. So we go down to new arrangement. And again, you can give it whatever name you want. I just want it to be as obvious as possible. So 1, 2, 4, 1. So that is 1, 2, 4, 1. First, second, last, and then we're going to repeat the first one again. So I go OK there. And once again, we're going to get rid of 3, but this time I'm going to drag down 1 to wherever I want it. I could repeat it right there, I could repeat it right there, but in this case I want to repeat it at the end. So that solves that problem. So we've got the first, the second, the last, and then the first again. So that's pretty cool. Now you might have noticed a problem though, in that the first verse has the background, and again it has it here. So you might think, oh, no problem, I will just right click and remove media action, and I want you to watch the top one as well. And when I do that, it goes away from both. So what's going on here? Well, what's going on is that there is only one verse 1. So this is exactly the same as this. So anything you do down here will automatically be done right here. So that's an important lesson to know about arrangements, is it's just pointing to the canonical version, the actual version in the master. It's pointing to that, and any changes you make in one place will affect other places. They will also affect other arrangements. So let's say I click disable right there. So that did disable the second slide in the first verse. Now if I go back to this one right here, notice it's affected as well. So basically every arrangement is, we see the slides, but in fact what it's just doing is pointing back to the master in that case. So what would I do if my worship leader said, yeah, I want to do the first, second, fourth verses, then I want to repeat the first verse again, but I only want to repeat the first slide of the first verse, the first two lines of the first verse. Well, first off, I would go back and enable that to fix that. But what I'm going to do in this case is I'm going to select both of these. Okay. And copy them. So go down to copy. That was right click and copy. To select them, I held down the command and clicked in Mac OS. I think control click will do the same thing in Windows. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click and paste. And notice that, of course, verse 1, blah, blah, blah. So now I've got 4 lines. That's no good. What I want to do is right here, the third one, the repeat of it, I'm going to right click and go down to group. And these are all the groups that are available. I can also add a new group if I wanted to. So let me just call this verse 5. And I know that it's not actually verse 5, but for this situation, we're going to treat it like verse 5. Okay, so now I have, in this arrangement, verse 1, 5, 2, 4, 1. Well, I don't need the second one, and verse 5 should actually be right here after verse 4. And then in this one, I can right-click and either disable or delete that slide. It doesn't really matter which I choose. But notice here, verse 1 is as it was, but now since, even though they're copied directly from verse 1, since it's a new group, I can do whatever I want to that. So, just as I disabled it, I can also delete it, and that doesn't affect verse 1 here. So, what would I do if I needed additional stuff, or if I needed a partial verse in this case? Well, I just showed you what to do with the partial verse. You just basically make a new copy of it and deal with it that way. If I wanted to add something additional right here, well, since this is only used this one time, I can absolutely add a new slide to that if I wanted to. Just click on the plus button down here, this little plus button, and then I could select the same theme and do that, and then add whatever I wanted to, you know, right click, quick edit, and type in what I wanted. Amazing grace. Oh yeah. So maybe this is, you know, a 1970s version. Oh yeah. I don't know. But whatever. Then I can do that. And so now I have basically this first verse that's up here. Except instead of I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind, but now I see, I have amazing, amazing grace, oh yeah. This, though, if I just wanted to repeat the amazing grace, oh yeah part, I might want to change that to a tag or a vamp or something. So I can right-click and go down to group, and let's call it a tag. So if I wanted to add the tag, maybe after the second verse up here, so I can just drag it right there, and now that shows up, amazing grace, oh yeah, after verse 2, it's there, and then after the half verse, which is verse 5, I can add that. So I really have a lot of flexibility. Notice, remember, going back to the master, I've added verse 5 and the tag. If we go back to the master, you'll notice verse 5 and the tag are there. So I might want to rearrange those in a way that makes sense to me. But going back to 1241, it's still in the same list here. So that's perfectly good. And now, by the way, instead of having four different entries in, or even five different entries in one of my libraries, I just have this one, which is Amazing Grace. The master has everything possible. The default arrangement, that's coming from Planning Center Online. Jerry, I've taught this particular one with this song before, and I mentioned him before. Then the 1-2-4 or the 1-2-4-1, I might want to change the name of that. So if I go down here to Arrangements Master, and so let's say I'm going to slowly double click on it. So click, wait a second, click again, and that enables me to change it. So this is 1, 2 tag 4, 5 tag, and that's good to go. And if I want to delete any of the arrangements, I can just select it and then click on the minus arrow here. And just so you know, if you right click on that, it doesn't do anything, so you do need to do the click, then slowly click again. So click it to select it, click it again so that you can get it highlighted so that you can change the name. So that is all about arrangements in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/pro, the number 7, and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free instead of the $29 that it would normally cost to get that course. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.